But in sport as in life, those exits don't just happen, even to once-in-a-generation talents like theirs, especially in a discipline so vulnerable to the vagaries of judging allegiances. So, left wanting something more after silver in Sochi, and after a needed respite from the mental and physical grind of training and competition, Tessa Virtue and Scott Moir set up shop in Montreal and built an ice dance machine that would not fail them. It was so thoughtfully constructed, its expert personnel handpicked, its support systems and redundancies rock solid. All they had to do was skate, which is what they still love to do together after a 20-year partnership. And, quite frankly, there is nobody in the world who does it better, with more innovation, athleticism and technical brilliance. The Olympic gold medals they won on Tuesday are emphatic symbols of their dominance here, but more significantly of the relentless pursuit of perfection. For a year now, Moir has told anybody who would listen that they had to be perfect to win their second Olympic gold. He knew how the judges were stacking this up, how the point differential between them and the French couple of Gabriela Papadakis and Guillaume Cizeron, their training partners, was going to be razor thin. He got all that right. Virtue and Moir led the French by 1.74 points after the short program. And on Tuesday, skating before Virtue and Moir hit the ice, Papadakis and Cizeron set a new world record of 123.35 in the free skate, another of 205.28 in the overall score. The stage looked set for a French victory, and the air was rife with hints of judging hijinks. But Moir and Virtue snatched their fates from the judges' hands and ensured the gold medals would be theirs by the end of the night. Their Moulin Rouge free dance seemed more powerful and more athletic than a low-key, classical and technically proficient French performance, but they finished a tick behind at 122.40. It was still enough to push Virtue and Moir to 206.07, to the top step, the perfect ending. "I don't think perfection really exists, to be honest," Moir said. "But we both said, afterwards, that we wouldn't want to go out and bid against that performance, if we had to go do it again. That's what we've been doing and that's what we can be proud of with all four skates. It's not a surprise. But on this stage, when the lights are so bright, and you want it so bad, the tendency is that the surprises come out of nowhere. So we just made sure we were focused and believed in it, and sport sometimes throws you a couple of curveballs, and we were able to control a couple of little things in the programs, but that's what we do every day. So I think perfection? No, I don't think so. But they were fantastic, they were excellent skates. And we are so proud of each and every moment we spent on the ice, and mostly because we were present."